All right, let's do this rapid fire.
You know what time it is, blood. Little rapid fire.
Rapid fire. You know what I'm
saying? It's called a nigga blood.
Yo, I'm ready.
Saying you ready?
I'm ready.
Favorite skater?
Favorite skater, Cater.
I shot.
Favorite video?
Favorite video. Ooh, I got a couple favorite videos. I'm going to say... Godspeed. Godspeed. I almost lied, nigga. I was finna say almost Cheese and Crackers. Cheese and Crackers used to be like my favorite skate video. Y'all ain't never seen Almost Cheese and Crackers. If you fuck with mini ramps, you gotta watch that, bro. But Godspeed is a very inspirational video for me, twin. Some of the ATL homeboys is in the video too, bro. When I seen that, I was like, what the fucking fuck? Bro, I sat at the skate park one day. I know I'm just yapping about this shit, but excuse me. My first time watching Godspeed, I was at the skate park. In the parking lot, didn't even skate. I clicked on Godspeed while I was finna eat my food before the sesh, cause I'm like an iPad kid, you feel me? I gotta watch YouTube while I eat. But I clicked on Godspeed finally. I was probably like a year and a half, 2 years late on it, but whatever. I finally clicked it. Bro, I was glued to it. I don't even like watching long videos, like skate videos or whatever. I don't like watching full lengths. I was glued to Godspeed though, bro. The music, the vibe, the niggas. Like, man, that shit was fire, bro. Godspeed for sure.
Minefield.
Favorite video part?
Favorite video part? Stop. I don't know about no favorite video part. This shit going fast already, bro. God damn, this shit. I ain't even in front of these niggas and I'm feeling pressure. My favorite video part? Damn, twin, I don't know. I don't got a favorite video part, I don't think, bro. Need that. I say need that. Fuck it.
An eye shot part. It's hard to say specific his
no facts, bro. Godspeed. Emotional. Oh my, the whole video is emotional for me, dude. That bitch was fire.
The real since day one part. How about that? That inspired me. So there you go.
Hell yeah. Favorite style.
Favorite
style. y'all know Julio? Man, hold on. I gotta show y'all Julio, twin. Hold on. Julio, a nigga from Atlanta. I think he from Atlanta. His at name is French Doe. I think I'm spelling it right. Yup. Julio, favorite style. Besides like Cater. If we talking about like a famous skater, bro, I like Cater for sure. I'm fucking with Cater. I ain't gonna lie, hold on, I got multiple favorite styles though, because I like Cater, but I also like T-Funk. I like both. I like the lackadaisical style and I like the super aggressive style too. I like both. But this is Julio. I think his name is Julio, if I'm not mistaken. I'm finna put y'all on to some underground shit, bro. He's like an underground, like Atlanta skater, bro. It's gas though. Is good. He just skates so chill. He got this chill ass style. It's like he's not trying, bro, at all, bro. I fuck with this nigga, bro. If y'all fuck with the Atlanta skaters, bro, y'all gotta tap in with Julio. Your front door on Instagram. I really want to glaze and just play a bunch of clips, but I'm not gonna do that. We gotta get back to this rapid fire. This shit gotta be rapid. All right.
Style. I mean, I want to say Dylan Reeder.
Hell yeah.
I like T-Funk for sure. Yeah, like him a lot.
Which skater had the biggest influence on the way you skate?
Which skater had the biggest influence on the way I skate? God damn. I don't know how I skate. I skate a bunch of different ways. It depend on what I'm wearing and how I'm feeling. Because some days I want to skate fast and just do like 50-50s like T-Funk. Some days I want to like chill and relax and like skate more like how I normally skate. I'd probably say Kader for sure, though, because, like, when I started back skating as an adult, bro, I was watching Kader like a motherfucker, bro. When I started back, that's what I was watching for sure. So I'd say probably him. When I was younger, though, I liked the niggas I liked Ishad a lot when I was young. I liked Chaz Ortiz, no. I liked Chaz Ortiz more before Ishad when I was young. So, like, Chaz Ortiz as a kid and then Kader. Two Steez-ass niggas.
I think it's a hybrid between Ishad and Tyshawn.
Nice.
Bro said T-Funk still 12. What do you mean?
Most talented skateboarder on planet Earth.
Most talented skateboarder on planet Earth? I might have to say Yuto. Is Yuto? Nah, Day One Song. Yeah, I seen Day One Song in Atlanta the other day, too. Or last weekend. Day One Song was in Atlanta, too. I was just talking about earlier when I started stream. Some of y'all probably ain't hear me, but I just met Mark Suchu in Atlanta. I met Mark Suchu last weekend. I did a little video with him real quick. Not like a full video, but, you know, I was just on there telling him he handsome and shit, you know, glazing. Nah, for real, though. He goated skateboarder in real life and on the video parts. Like, cool, chill dude. But nah, Day One was out there, too. Day One is definitely one of the most talented skateboarders on planet Earth. Maybe the most talented skateboarder on planet Earth. Like, the nigga can do anything, bro. Like, anything. Twin can do anything. I ain't never really just seen him jump down big sets and stuff, but I don't think he can't. You get me? I don't think he can't do it. I think he's probably kind of like me and just don't prefer to do that.
I think I'm going to give it between Jamie and Tyshawn. I'm sorry, I can't give one.
Yeah, Day One is always like that, bro.
I think they're both extremely... I think they both, you know, front crooking El Toro and then Tyshawn's pop is just two things that are just like, who knows when we're going to see that again. You know?
Yeah, real shit.
I mean, we do got... I forget how to say her name, Momji.
Y'all be glazing, Tyshawn.
She could front crook a 16. That's fucked. So, props to her. I seen them at a dinner.
Nah, he good, but together. It was he like good as fuck.
An iconic moment. So,
glaze.
Yes, bro. Favorite trick.
Favorite trick.
Ooh, probably kickflip. To be real, I be kickflipping like a motherfucker. I just love to do kickflips. For no reason, I'ma just hit a little kickflip for no reason. All different type of ways, pop it high. Sometimes I try to do the lowest kickflip I possibly can. You know what I mean? Sometimes I try to do kickflip just right away 1 foot. Sometimes I do kickflip, cross foot. I kind of like heel flips equally too though. Gotta do heel flips the same way, just a little lazy heel flips or whatever. But I really love tray flips, but it's not like my favorite trick as far as like me doing them. I don't do tray flips as much as I kickflip. I do them down near as much as kickflips, but I do kickflips a lot, bro. I do a lot of just kickflip, bro. But, yeah. Check as far back. As tricks that I be doing and shit, though, like, just on the ground. But I tell my young homie this all the time, too. Anson, he done asked me this before, too, what my favorite trick is. Like, if I really have to just narrow it down to that one that I do all the time, then yeah, maybe that. But honestly, I love all tricks equal. I just love skateboarding, bro. Like, shit be fun, dude. Landing any trick feels good, dude. As long as you do it good. Even if you don't do it good, bro. Like, I like the sketchy lands and all, twin. Like, as long as I'm landing the trick, bro, that shit be feeling good, bro. I be doing little dumbass slappy tricks and little crazy style variations on quarter pipes. Like, so, I do manual tricks, all that type of shit, bro. Like, I just like skateboarding, dog. Like, that shit be fun, bro. Whatever I land is my favorite trick in that moment. But I guess overall, it'll probably be kickflip, yo, for sure.
Back nose once.
Hardest trick for you?
Ooh, hardest trick for me is a back Smith. I've never completed a backside Smith grind. Never done a back Smith in my whole life. Not even nollie back Smith, I don't think. I don't think I did nollie back Smith. Matter of fact, maybe I have done nollie back Smith, so I won't even say back Smith. I say front feeble. I've never done front feeble, dude. Never. Like, back Smith and front feeble is two tricks that just, like, them bitches hard for me to answer. But I ain't never did no front feeble variation except, like, on the quarter pipe. But, like, I can't front feeble, man. It just don't work for me, bro. Shit, crazy.
Fucking big spin back tails, man. Fucking.
Niggas say older dudes hated on Day One and Kareem.
Hate that shit. I was struggling.
You doing them all the time, man.
Is this JB that be at the park? Is this JB the bro?
I tried for like an hour and a half, 2 hours at the outledge that I skated in Berlin, Germany on my last Instagram post that I like back nose bunted and fakie front blunted. I was struggling, but yeah, I think that that's like the hardest trick.
Who hating on day
There's
one?
No tricks you.
Are you talking about them niggas?
Oh, I mean, it's like a trick that I could do that I just when I tried, it's really fucking hard. But tricks that I cannot do pop. But it's the same thing. It's kind of similar, but I cannot pop shove it. It's weird. I cannot pop shove it. I can only do a switch, but I can big spin back tail. But it's not the same thing. Cannot pop shove it. So that's your answer.
That's a good one. Now we're back.
Most illegal trick.
Oh, this is another. I love this question right here too. Nigga ass say most illegal trick. Hold on, let me get my chat back right how it was, because I hate looking over here. Most illegal trick? Listen here, twins. No such thing, bro. It's no such thing as an illegal trick. I could not answer that question for you if I wanted to. No trick is illegal, bro. Any trick that you land is legal. And any trick that you make look good is legal, twin. It's motherfuckers, excuse me, Jeff One Song do all type of tricks, bro. Like all type of tricks that a lot of people would deem illegal. Them bitches make him feel good. I guarantee you when he roll away, this nigga feel good as hell, twin. As long as you feel good when you land that motherfucker and you can do it good, consistent, make it look good. That shit not illegal, bro. It's no such thing as an illegal trick, bro. A trick is a damn trick, twin. No such thing. Now, it's tricks that I hate to, like, have a nigga do. I hate for a nigga to do on offense if we playing skate. It's certain tricks that I might hate to see a nigga do, but that's only because I suck at them, probably. But, like, or it might just be a weird trick, like a pop shove it front side sex change. Like that shit goofy as hell. If I had to just call a trick illegal, that might be what I called illegal. But even then, man, that shit's a trick. And I see niggas do it and feel good about it when they do it. So, man, more power to you, nigga. Ain't no such thing as illegal in skateboarding, in my personal opinion.
The legal trick? I fucking hate pressure flips. Suck. Trash.
Benny Hunter? You can't say Benny Hunter, twin. You can't say Benny Hunter is illegal, bro. I like Benny Hunter's twin. I can do Benny Hunter on flat ground. On my mama, I can. I can do it. But I can't do it off a ramp. I can do it on flat ground, though.
I want to see. Crazy.
Favorite clip you've ever gotten?
Favorite clip? I think there's three of them, but I guess the top would be...
Oh, favorite clip you ever got? Damn, I'm over here just listening. I tuned back in. I don't know. I ain't got nothing I'm super proud of yet so far. I do have a favorite clip, maybe, though. I got a couple favorite clips. I did a tray flip hill bomb in Atlanta, and I had to swerve a couple cars, and one of them, like, honked the horn at me. Like, that was pretty cool. That was just, like, a cool clip overall. But, I mean, it was just a tray flip, so it was nothing too crazy. And then I got another trick. I think I mentioned it earlier. I did a 50-50 gap to 50. It's like these rusty rails that was like angled. It was angled crazy like this. And I had the 50-50 and then gap like the corner to 50-50 at like a right angle down there. I got that clip. That was pretty cool. And I did a full cab flip down like this little grass gap in my hometown. Did a full cab kick flip down that. I never full cab flip down anything a day in my life before I did that. I just was like, fuck it, let's try it, and I did it. So, yeah, that's like three tricks that I fought with a lot, but I still ain't did nothing I'm really proud of, though. I ain't even fucking without none of that shit, bro, to be real. I got to get more shit.
Fuck. I mean, can I say this? Just the three?
Let's see what.
There's three of them.
I mean, that's crazy, because I literally just said 3-2. I did not know Buddy was going to say 3-2.
Like my favorite. Back nose bump flushing, nollie train to triangle, and the backside flip. Those are my three.
Ooh, nollie train to the triangle is dope. I think I actually seen that clip, and I didn't even know who Buddy was.
Favorite.
Nice.
Hell yeah, it's a banger.
Hold on. I've been ignoring chat. Let me see what y'all saying. Yeah, it's all about motive. It's all about the motive when it comes to the illegal tricks, for sure. Willie's definitely not illegal, because this nigga named Garrett that be at the local, this nigga can do Willie's, and he make that shit look good. Like, I don't know how the fuck he can do it. Like, on a down rail. Nigga says, stank leg trays. Nigga, stank leg trays are fire. You tweaking. Full cab flip is done. Y'all don't like full cab flip? That trick is dope. Y'all niggas tweaking. Everyone is not doing less flip tricks, bro. You niggas not on the same part of the internet as me. I see all types of skating on my feed. I see pool skating. I see like the Miles Silver style, just like classic skateboarding. I see like the Jeff One Song type shit. Niggas doing crazy like random tricks and shit, bro. I see the Jason Parks. I be seeing all that shit, bro. Y'all talking about niggas not doing flip tricks too. And I see everything. Y'all probably just ain't looking.
Worst trend you've been a part of?
Worst trend you've been a part of? Damn, when I was a kid, twin. Man, when I was young, bro. Skinny jeans, slip-on Vans, and probably like them striped t-shirts. Like, t-shirt be striped. It'll be like a V-neck. Like, I have on like some skinny jeans, some slip-on Vans, and like a striped V-neck t-shirt. It'll be like a striped V-neck t-shirt with a backward snapback. And then I have on some shades, and like the side of the shades got a color on them. Like, just like whatever color my shoes was or some shit. Like, the side of the shades would be like that color or something. And like, man, and I probably had on like a necklace or something, like a shell necklace though. Like, not even no drip shit. Like a rosary. Nah, that's what I used to be rocking, rosaries. Man, I was on the fucking flow to, and I was told to fuck up to, on the flizzo. That shit was bad, bro. I got a video on my channel, if y'all want to go find it, where I was roasting my old clips. You'll see what I mean probably in that video. I think I might have posted some shit from around that era. Man, that shit was bad, twin. Skinny jeans, too. I'm not talking about slim pants cut off at the ankles. I'm talking about skinny jeans, twin. Like, girl pants, twin. Girl pants with a striped V-neck, bro. And a snapback backwards, and I got on some color side shades, bro, with some slip-on Vans, bro. Like, what the fuck was I on, dude? I thought I was a bad bitch. I was going to the park thinking I was a bad bitch. The fuck was he on, man? Y'all niggas should have beat me up.
Maybe Vulcan pants.
Bro, so I ain't ashamed of shit, twin. I was ashamed.
That's awesome.
Gnarliest trick you've ever witnessed?
I don't know about gnarliest trick I ever witnessed. I ain't never just witnessed no super crazy shit that I can remember, to be real. Nah, you right though. Shit was different back then. Oh my mom, shit did used to be different back then. Oh God. Hey, pink and black BAM Element gear. Oh my mom, I had the audios. Y'all remember them audio shoes, bro? Hold on. Y'all remember them pink and black hologram audios? I know y'all know what I'm talking about, twin. Or was it DVS? I think it was audios. I know y'all know what I'm talking about. Was it not audios? Hold on. I'm just typing pink and black hologram shoes. Because maybe it was DVS. Nah, it's not none of these, twin. Dude. Is that not audio or is that DVS? Bro. I ain't never have these, but the females used to get these and shit. But, dude, it's not these, but it's like these. Oh, that is audio. Maybe that is what I'm talking about. That's not what I'm talking about, bro. They had a hardogram on it, bro. Like, it was the Bam Margera shit. Y'all know what I'm talking about, though, bro. Shit like that, nigga. Nigga used to wear shit like that, bro. Nigga. Tripping, bro. Oh, it's audio. Okay. For sure. I'm spelling it like audio. But, you know.
Shit, Jamie's,
Hey, literally. Hey, hold on real quick. Story, twin. I used to like Bam so much, twin. When I was young, I used to watch, like, Viva La Bam and all that type of shit. I got my mama to get me this Element board. I got my mama to get me this skateboard right here for what you call it. It was either for like my birthday or for Christmas, if this shit would load. This board right here. I got my mama to get me this dumbass, stupid, bitch-ass fucking skateboard. Why the fuck my shit won't freaking load, twins? I got my mama to buy me this dumbass shit, bro, for my birthday, bro. And tell me why I loved this board so much, twin, when I got it. Dude, it was complete. So it had the trucks on it and everything. Tell me why, bro. I put my pillow on top of the board right here. I put my pillow right there on the middle of the board, and I slept on top of that bitch. Uncomfortable as hell. Hard wood up under my motherfucking head. Pause, twin. Pause. Don't take that and run with it, twins. You get what I'm saying? Don't take it and run with it. You guys know I'm not that. No, for real, though. I put my fucking pillow under this shit and slept with that bitch, bro. I loved that skateboard, bro, for no reason. I don't even remember skating it or getting any clips on it or anything, bro, but I remember having it and sleeping on that bitch like a damn idiot. I was wigging. No, I skipped. I didn't even mean to do that.
Last new trick I learned. I want
to. No. We're going too far back.
Favorite clip.
Okay.
Can I say this? Just the three?
Where we at?
The rail grind. You guys are good.
Hey, nah, for real, twin. I'm my mama, twin. I'm my mama. I did that, bro. I did it, bro.
Gonna see it.
Yeah, I gotta see this.
I think it might be a. You'll see. I don't know. We'll see.
What's the one trick that got away?
I ain't got a trick that got away. I ain't got a trick that got away, y'all, cause I don't be in the. I be in the streets filming, but like, I don't be in the streets filming like that. Oh, I do got a trick that got away, but it ain't got away cause it ain't like I can't go back and get it. I just haven't went back to go get it cause I'm fucking lazy and stupid and fucking pitiful. But I got a clip. I can't say it right now. I can't say it cause some of the bros might be on here and I don't need my trick getting took. It's like, it's a local tree. It's like a local spot. I can't see it.
Oh, kickflip back nose one Zukai.
The one.
Oh, no. Matter of fact, I do got a trick that got away. I tried to, I did kickflip back tail. I was trying to kickflip back tail big spin down El Toro, but they tore down the spot. So, like, I never could get the clip. And, like, when I went there, like, I got real close. I kept sticking it, but, like, I didn't have a filmer. So, I just, like, walked away. You know, I didn't have a filmer down there to capture the moment. So, I just left, you know.
For it, that's why I knocked
it. What's
it would have went down for sure though. I just didn't have the film. And then by the time I went back to try to like have a filmer and get it filmed properly, the spot was gone, you know, so I just couldn't do it. Like that would have been my debut. I definitely would have went pro and shit then. I would have been like one of the top guys, but I got discouraged after that moment and I just kind of fell back from skating, you know, like it'd be like that sometimes.
Smith front side flip.
Yeah, I got close to kickflip back noseband in three tries the first time I went there. And then every time it's kind of just been like a mental battle of me trying it.
What's the last new trick you learned?
Last new trick I learned, I want to say maybe.
No, actually, it's crazy you mentioned Sheckler because Sheckler was there. Ryan Sheckler was there. He was there. Hold on. Last trick I learned. Don't know what happened to the fried dude who copyright claimed him. What did happen to that dude, man? What did happen to the dude, man? Where is he at, man? Nah, he been posting, though. I watched one of his videos the other day. He apologized to me, and he, like, refollowed me on Instagram and shit. Like, he tried to, like, make amends, but I hold grudges. I did not accept the apology. I didn't. I'm sorry. I'm a bad dude for that. It seemed like a very sincere apology. Like, he felt bad for what he did, but fuck it. Last trick I learned, I say I've been working on front Smith kickflip. I've been trying to get them front Smith kickflip out. I ain't landed yet, though. I only tried it a handful of times, though. I ain't tried it the whole lot. So maybe that doesn't even count as, like, newest trick I learned. I can't really think of another trick that I've tried to learn, though, since before that. I don't know. I don't really got one. I was at a point where I wasn't even really trying to learn new tricks. I had just been out filming. I was out filming for a second, but then I stopped filming. And I just recently started like trying to learn new tricks. And Front Smith Kickflip was it though. The only thing that I can think of that I've like practiced recently that I didn't already have. Yeah, that's all I can think of, to be real. Yeah, that might be it, man. I don't know.
I feel like I mean, what I remember, I know that there's something in front of that, but back when 80 switched from crook, or something like alley-oop.
Nice.
Oh, that's a cool trick. Wait. Oh, yeah, alley-oop. That's hot. Yeah, that's fine.
Dream job after skating.
I don't skate as a job, so
Luxury car sales.
Oh, sick. Sick. Favorite local brand?
Poets is local. That's nice. Might not might be good for business, be a sponsor, but I like Gino. So sorry, Joe. I like Dickies too.
You love Dickies.
I love Dickies.
We love Dickies.
We love Dickies.
Hey, yo. What the fuck is you niggas talking about?
Yeah,
fact. Shouts to Dickies. Honeymoon. Joe, you killed it.
Joe killed it.
Favorite local skater?
Favorite.
My favorite local skater, like from where I'm at right now in the Mac. My favorite making skateboarder. Let me see. My favorite local skater. I'm gonna show you. I think it's gonna have to be this guy. I be remembering usernames, dude. This is not him. He has an extra underscore on his name. I be remembering usernames, dude. This is my favorite local skater. His name is Evan.
Hey! He finished it.
Where these niggas range? Oh my god.
Hey! He finished it.
This nigga is buck like in real life though. Like, God damn, my shit slow as hell. My shit over slow. Yeah. He's him, bro, in real life. I swear these clips ain't really like doing him justice. You gotta see him. Y'all gotta see this nigga skating in real life. He skates like, the way these clips are, he skates like this in real life all the time. You feel me? It's not like these are just the clips. He's not one of them guys that just has good clips. He literally skates like this in real life. Like, as y'all can see, this nigga just be propping his motherfucking phone up, bro. He just be propping his phone up and just getting the clip on his own. Like, he don't really be giving it down. But, yeah, that's my favorite, whatchamacallit, local skater, Evan.
Favorite local skater. There's just my homie Leo. No one's going to know who he is, but my homie Leo. I don't know how to say the last name. He's sick. He's getting back into skating again. Oh, and then there's James Rear.
What's the next question?
It's just back to kickflip.
Wow. This is fire though. I ain't gonna lie. I ain't never did no little rapid fire shit. This is fire. Whoever suggested that I do this, this was fire. I fought with that. That was a great idea.
What's the one sponsor you regret riding for?
Ooh, the one sponsor I regret riding for? Y'all probably don't remember. This was back in the day when Nike SB first started sponsoring skateboarders. I was on the team. I went pro for Nike SB way back then. I regret riding for them though, because like, I don't know, it just really wasn't really my style, you know, like, I didn't really fit the team, you know, dude, like, it just wasn't really for me, you get me?
Fuck, I feel like a dick saying this. I'm sorry, shut New York City, I'm sorry.
All good. Favorite?
And now, honestly, though, why would you even answer that question? I don't think if you're gonna feel like a dick saying it, why the fuck would you answer it? You could just plead the fifth, nigga. Stupid ass.
Teammate ever.
I'm sorry. Favorite teammate ever, Jamie Foy.
Favorite teammate, nigga, I ain't had none.
Boy.
Worst teammate ever.
Worst teammate ever.
Yeah, I did have some teammates, but that shit don't count. I was on the kid sponsors, dude. I was not, like, sponsored for real when I was actually, like, skating for real. I had little kid clothing sponsors.
Fucking Lem Villaman.
And I had a little kid board sponsor.
No, that day doesn't
anymore. Oh shit! Is there a story with that one? A quick one?
Oh, I was fake asleep, so I had to act like I didn't have to.
Next question.
Worst company.
Worst company. Worst company. Worst Company. You know what's so crazy about this company, bro? I literally just seen a nigga at the skate park earlier today. Grown man, by the way. Skateboarding. Doing skateboard maneuvers. Riding a Braille skateboard. 7.75. Grown man, by the way. Grown man. Probably 5'9", 5'10 in height. Maybe 5'10 and a half or so. Grown man. Had to wear about a size 10 shoe. No more than like 29, 30 years old. Grown man, by the way. Was riding a 7.75 Braille skateboard. In real life. In real life, bro. I never in my life seen one of these boards in real life. I always wondered to myself, how the fuck do Braille make money? Do they make money off skateboards or just off their YouTube? Come on, my mom, I never seen a Braille skateboard in real life. And you know what else is crazy about this situation? It broke on a flat ground trick. He did like a fucking, what did he try, like a hard flip? No, I think he tried an inward heel flip or some shit on flat ground. Broke it. Broke the tail. Just goes to show you. Terrible. Terrible company. If I had to say so myself. I never grew up watching Braille either, so I can say that. So y'all can't ever act like I just switched up or something, like how a lot of these other niggas did, switched up when they found out about the Scientology shit. I never watched Braille. I ain't never give a fuck about that shit. I just know Braille always seemed like a fucking myth. Like, you never see that shit in the wild.
Oh, Paolo Peralta.
Yo, this nigga say Paolo Peralta. He say, was it Aaron? Hell no. Nah. This nigga said, was it Aaron? On God, too. I swear that's how it is, bro. For real, like, you never seen nobody skating that shit except for Braille niggas. Like, dead ass. I can't say the berries. But I don't know. Hold on. Yeah. I'm just watching reading the chats. My bad, yeah. But it's, they never even knew about him until the drama. Good. Boy, say inward heel on a Braille board. It's definitely the combo. But this nigga here, we back to this nigga. On his ass, twin. This nigga here say, he said, worst company is, whatchamacallit, this nigga said, worst company is Paolo Peralta? Huh? Okay, I kind of get what he's saying, though, probably. Because nowadays, Paolo is a whole lot different than Paolo Peralta. But I don't even think it's Paolo Peralta no more. I think it's just Paolo. I don't think it's Paolo Peralta no more. I don't think there's any Stacy Peralta involvement in Paolo. I don't know.
Oh, they OG, man. You got to respect the OGs.
Yeah, I don't know. That might be bad because it's like Bone Swiss. I'm sorry, Vern.
Guy's digging himself a hole, man.
Hey, shouts Vern, man.
Shout out Vern. Nah,
me and Donald are flying around on our Swiss these days.
He really fucked with me. He's giving me so many Swiss ads. I think I've had 3 Swiss ads, which is crazy.
Bro got 3 Swiss ads and hating on Paolo Peralta, man.
Hell yeah.
That's crazy.
Worst trend.
Think like, just like.
No facts. I'm not a fanboy of Paolo Peralta, but that shit is crazy to hear based off of, like, the time period I grew up skating hard. Nigga, I was playing Tony Hawk Underground. If y'all recall on Tony Hawk Underground 1, if y'all recall on the Tony Hawk Underground 1 cutscenes, Tony Hawk Underground 1, the first person that you try to impress with your footage, Stacy Peralta. First person you try to impress with your footage is Stacy Peralta. You try to get hooked up with Paolo Peralta. You feel me? And so, like, that was, like, my real introduction to him. Like, I had heard of him from listening to, like, I used to watch skateboarding documentaries and all that type of shit as a kid. But, yeah, this game, that was my first real introduction to Stacy Peralta and the whole Paolo Peralta agenda or whatever. So, like, since back fucking then, bro. And what year did that game come out? Tony Hawk Underground. That came out in 2000. No, nigga. They talking about the song. That came out in 2003. Dude, I was skateboarding in 2003? I don't think I was skateboarding. I couldn't have been actually riding skateboards in 2003. I don't think I started skating until like 2005. But anyway, yeah, that introduced me to that way back then. So to hear a nigga say that
too baggy
20 years later,
too overdone, crazy. Like that. Yeah, I don't fuck with that shit. It's just like, I just feel like it's not.
Hold on, what did this nigga say?
Dang, crazy.
Hell yeah. Damn. Worst trend.
Think.
Worst trend. All right, buddy. All right, Chili Rilio, whatever the hell your name is. All right, PK. I'm finna get out of this motherfucker to y'all after this, what you call it, but after this rapid fire, I gotta see this shit through. I'm down sure getting tired though. But worst trend. Worst trend. What is the worst trend in skateboarding? I don't know. I fuck with all trends, bro. People express themselves differently in fashion. I be feeling like one of them super positive niggas saying shit like that, but yeah, me personally, I fuck with all the trends, bro. I fuck with the niggas that wear the slacks with a tank top tucked in, and the cuff with Vans and shit. I fuck with that style. I fuck with the niggas that wear the big ass pants too. I fuck with that shit too. I fuck with the niggas that still skate skinny jeans, like Cannon Dern and Dalton Dern. Them niggas still skate skinny jeans, and them niggas are dope ass individuals on and off the board. Like, I fuck with them boys too. Like, you know, I fuck with their style. Shit, Jeff still skates skinny jeans. You feel me? I fuck with his style. Hell, Gifted Hater be skating fucking like relaxed fit jeans and shit. Fuck with his style too. Like, I don't really see. Ain't nothing wrong with the trend shit, in my opinion. Hell, then one nigga, I can't remember his name off top, but one of the bros that I had met out in LA, his ass skate like opium as fuck. Like, he be wearing like the beanies and shit, like the little spiderweb beanies and all that type of shit. Like, that shit be fighting me too, though. I like all that shit, bro. Any style that you really own is the best style for you, bro. I don't think it's the worst style. I say, yeah, the worst style is when it look like a nigga dressed you. Anybody that looks like they've been dressed by somebody else. And you know what I mean when I say that. Like, nigga that look uncomfortable in their clothes, like they trying too hard to look a certain way, that's the worst style. That's the only way you got a bad style, is if you trying too hard, like you overdoing it. Like, just be yourself, and that's the best style.
Like, just like two baggy pants, like too overdone, like that. Yeah, I don't fuck with that shit. It's just like,
oh yeah, I don't think if they was talking about trick trends, then yeah, ride on grinds was one of them at one point for me until I started doing them bitches. I used to be like, bro, niggas is grown as hell riding onto their grind, grown ass man doing ride on grinds. But then I realized that shit low key fun. I tried it a few times. Them bitches fine.
I just feel like it's not real. I feel like if someone didn't start that, it wouldn't have could been continued. I think it's just unnecessary. Just the right amount of bag, just the right amount of baggies. Cool.
Worst style.
Fuck, dude. I feel like
if he talking about skateboarders. Hold on, I gotta see what he finna say. Hold on,
because he always likes my shit. But I'm sure. I'm not the only person to say it on it, but Jeff.
Don't see, do it to me.
Knew these niggas were finna say that shit. I knew these niggas were finna say that shit.
This season we might have.
I knew this nigga was finna say that goof ass shit, man. Next nigga out here talking crazy about Jeff One song. I'm coming through up and switch on your ass, twin. What's this nigga name? What's it, Frankie Spears? Let me catch you, boy. It's up. It's up by Jeff Twin. Y'all ain't gonna stop doing that. Y'all ain't gonna learn to stop doing that, though. Y'all ain't gonna learn to stop doing that. Coming on the butt talking shit like that by Jeff. And you talking about I'm gonna feel so bad. He always likes my posts. Shut the fuck up, nigga.
You have to forbid
people. That nigga don't know you, nigga.
People from coming at
Jeff. That nigga Jeff don't even fuck with you for real. He told me, nigga.
Jeff.
Nah, he didn't, but I bet he don't now, nigga.
Is that what everyone says?
Yeah.
Fuck, nigga.
I'm at Jeff.
He's been I like him. I think he's really good at skating. I watch his stuff myself. I just like...
Nigga trying to make it sound better now. Goofy ass nigga.
I didn't know that. I didn't know you could skate so long and it could not get any better. I didn't know that. Like, you think...
What's up with you, homie? What's up with you?
Like, his kickflip at some point would flick. Just always down. Hold down.
Bro, we got no words for you.
What's up with you, homie? Violating, twin. Like, doing too much. Like, it gets to a point. You feel me? It gets to a point.
He's Jeff, an amazing skater, though. Inward heel, Hollywood.
Jeff is Bunt Gang for That's life, crazy. Man. That fool came to the Bunt Jam and put on for the city.
I know.
He yeah.
Jeff wants on.
Did you?
Goofy. He wears a G-Unit shirt.
All yeah. the time.
This nigga, y'all be talking about Jeff wearing G-Unit. Y'all niggas don't know Jeff, twin. Y'all don't know Jeff, twin. Jeff does not wear a G-Unit shirt all the time. He wears G-Unit shirts, but he's sponsored by a brand that makes shirts in the same style as the G-Unit shirts. Y'all don't be looking hard enough. His apparel sponsor, that's just their style of, like, graphic tees. They copy the G-Unit style clothes because they know it's, like, trendy or whatever a little bit. So that's why it look like he always wearing a G-Unit shirt. Them bitches don't be G-Unit shirts. You think I'm lying? Go look on his Instagram right now. Go look, nigga.
Frankie, last but not least, man.
Yeah, get him out of here. Last question. Get him out.
Who's the last person you want on the sesh?
Last person I want on the sesh? Frankie Spears. Last person I want on the sesh, Frankie Spears. And with that, I don't even want to hear who this nigga got to say. With that, we out of here, man. Hey, if y'all fucking with me, tap into the website and shit. Like I showed y'all earlier, I got new shirts on the website. These skateboarding, these stupid tees, you know, I got all colors. Not all colors, but I got a bunch of colors, a bunch of different flavors on these bitches. Skateboarding, these stupid tees, going crazy. They're on my website right now. The link is in the bio, xiii.store. They only like, what, $20, $30, I think? They $30 right now. Might go on a little sale soon. If I see people really fucking with them, maybe, I might put them on a sale. It's probably be a minute, though. Gotta get some of them off first, but they only like $30. Little skateboarding, these stupid tees. Just support the brand, support the channel. And I'm gonna start back streaming on here a lot more often. I might not be uploading a whole lot of like actual full videos and shit for real in the near future just because the streaming shit is more fun to me. I like doing this. I like the real time interactions with real people. This shit is fire. I fuck with this way more than just talking to my motherfucking camera for no reason and then having to sit here and wait for it to upload for hours and hours and hours and hours and then the shit only get like fucking 2,000 views. So I fuck with this, bro. I was finna say get in the comment box, like, come subscribe, but all that shit goes without being said. Just tune in for the next stream. Maybe I'll start doing announcements or something like the day of stream or a day before I do the stream so y'all can know to tune in or I don't fucking know. I probably just stream randomly like I'm doing right now. I don't need this shit to feel like a job for me, honestly. I need this shit to just be as free as possible but still enjoyable for you guys because if I start doing it like too much, I feel like the content gonna suffer too. And then if the content suffer, then the viewers suffer and we never want that. So, alright, enough yapping. I'm out of this motherfucker, man. It's getting late. I fuck with y'all, man. I fuck with you guys, bro. For real, for real. I gotta remember how I'm supposed to end this shit because I didn't start it from YouTube.